So you might be asking yourself, what are the other sites that I need to list my short-term rental on in 2022? Well, in today's video here on AJ Hustles, I'm gonna talk exactly what are those other platforms that I'm listing my property on and where you should list yours as well. But before we get there, if you could smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm, I don't know why I put a fist, but if you could smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm, I would be forever grateful. All right, and let's just address the elephant in the room. Obviously, Airbnb has made some crazy changes on its platform, either for good or worse, depending on how you're sitting. Hosts love it or hosts hate the new categories piece of the new update. And so far, I haven't seen a big change in at least my listing, but who knows how this is gonna turn out. All that I know is that it is our job as hosts to be as flexible as we can and adapt when the market or marketplaces that we list our particular listings on change. So we need to be as adaptable as possible. And if you'd like me to do an entire video on what I'm doing, particularly on the Airbnb platform with these new categories and with the changes and how the search engine optimization is a little bit different, let me know in the comments and I will make sure to do a video here in the next week so that I can send that information to all of you as quickly as possible. But now back to the topic at hand. In business, we are told that diversification is good, whether that's diversifying your investments, whether it's diversifying your 401k, whatever it is, we know that diversification is good because it helps us ride out those periods of instability. Now, the same is true with your short-term rentals. You shouldn't just be listing your short-term rental on one platform because it means that you actually have more risk if something were to happen just on that one particular platform, which I think is what we're seeing with a lot of these category changes at Airbnb. I've heard too many horror stories on Facebook or in other groups that I'm a part of where somebody's listing on Airbnb gets shut down for 2, 3, or 4 months because of some error or some bot or something happens at the property and they're not able to list it on that particular property. So by diversifying this and having multiple different listings across multiple different websites, you're going to be able to mitigate that risk by making sure that you have some place to get that revenue from outside of just one platform. So let's talk about those other platforms where you should list your property. Starting with number one, which is VRBO. Now you've probably already heard of VRBO. There's really the top two or three big names in short-term rentals. Airbnb, VRBO are definitely at the top. Now VRBO is a little bit more of a classic short-term rental website. It's very traditional. You know, the types of people who are actually renting on that platform aren't necessarily millennials or younger people. They tend to skew more towards the older generation. They're just used to that type of platform. So that also means that there are advantages of using that platform as well. Now, there's really not much of a difference in setting up your property between Airbnb and VRBO. VRBO isn't as user-friendly, but there are some key differences when it comes to fees. Now, the fees on VRBO are significantly higher than they are on Airbnb. There's a 5% host fee as well as a 3% processing fee. So compared to the Airbnb 3% flat rate, you'll be paying more along the lines of an 8% kind of commission and fee-based structure with VRBO. Now, a couple of callouts with VRBO, at least from what I've noticed on the platform, is that it's a little bit harder to interact with guests. It's harder to get guest information, and guests really don't communicate as much as they do. It's also really difficult to get reviews from guests after they've stayed. So that's one thing that you should really be aware of, is that if you're able to get those reviews on VRBO and you're able to bump your listing up by getting really good at getting those reviews, that is definitely one way that you can stand out. Now let's move on to number two, which is booking.com. Now this is by far not my favorite site, but it is something that I have gotten a few bookings through. But there is a big kicker between VRBO, Airbnb, and booking.com. Booking.com basically takes all of the fees that they would charge to someone who's a guest on the platform, and they pass that off to the host, meaning that your commission fee is basically around 15%. Now, this is a big change between the 3% commission that you're paying on Airbnb, the 8% commission in total that you're paying on VRBO, and the 15% commission that you'd be paying on booking.com. So you'd want to make sure that you optimize your prices accordingly in order to make sure that you are making as much revenue as you possibly can through each one of these sites. Now, one of the big differentiators is that Booking.com and its affiliate sites get you a ton of views. So if you're looking for views and traffic and you think you got a great conversion, then this is definitely something that you want to take advantage of because they have a really, really large network where they can show your property to a ton of people who are looking, depending on the market that your Airbnb is in. So let's move on to number three, which is Haufi. Now, Haufi is a smaller website that I use mainly for my direct bookings. Now, I collect guest email addresses, and then what I do with that is I add that to a database, and I will send weekly emails out to my guests to let them know any availability, give them particular discounts, as well as send them directly to my Haufi website where they can book, sign a rental contract, and it's super, super easy. And in the end, I'm making more money because my fees are a little bit elevated, but the guest is actually paying less. So it really is a win-win. Now, Haufi also does advertising on its particular website. I haven't ever paid for the feature promotion or whatever promotion type of deal that they have on their website. I might try it in the future, but that will basically lift your listing in their rankings for a couple of dollars, depending on the type of date range that you're looking for. And that might be a way that you can get some guests as well. I've only ever had one guest actually book who was not a previous guest on Haufi. So it is something that you could look into and maybe you'll get lucky and a lot of people will be looking at Haufi in your neighborhood. But I would definitely suggest it if you have a list where you're sending people to basically do direct bookings. And also let me know if you're interested in some of the ways that I do direct bookings. I think it's probably as I continue to get more and more guests spending money at my places, I definitely wanna move towards that direct booking line because I think it's actually a much more profitable and a much more sustainable way to move forward with getting my property booked. All right, now let's move to the last website where I have not listed, but I will be listing it in the next week, which is Expedia. And maybe it's just me, but every time I say Expedia, I just hear the Expedia.com. Now this website I haven't actually used quite yet, so I can't really give you any direct feedback on it. I will be listing my property on there this week, but commission fees are a little bit different. They can be anywhere from 10 to 30% commission for Expedia. So that's definitely something that you're gonna have to take into account. I don't know what my commission is quite yet on the platform, but once I do, I will let all of you know. I think it depends on property size as well as property area. And of course, the Expedia network is very large as well. So this will get you even more visibility to travelers and other people who are looking for short-term stays. Now again, by listing your property on multiple of these platforms, you are going to decrease your risk that you're going to have some sort of revenue cut because somebody shuts down your listing on one platform. But again, you're gonna get a lot more visibility. And the great thing is that if you can take some time to lower those prices on some of these platforms to get some of those initial reviews, then you're going to be able to even further optimize your revenue strategy across multiple platforms. And so even though I might be taking a little bit of a hit on some of these platforms in the short term, I really think that it is going to benefit myself and my business in the long term. And my goal is basically to get a bunch of VRBO reviews in the next few months so that I can continue to push my listing on that platform. And then I'll do the same with Booking.com as well as Expedia here within the next year. That's basically my strategy, but of course, everyone can do this totally different. Now, if you are looking at finding, financing, or evaluating a short-term rental deal, feel free to let me know at ajhustlesyt@gmail.com. Love to jump on a call with you. I've already been able to help multiple different people as they're looking at finding or financing or evaluating some of the short-term rental deals within their own markets in order for them to be successful. I also talk a lot on those calls about how to optimize their current listings, how they can get more revenue, what are other places they should be listing their particular Airbnb, all of that fun stuff. So I hope to hear from you and we'll talk then. And that's it for today's video. I will see you in the next one.